Hi guys! Sa pagpapatuloy ng ating series for Thermodynamics, ang pag-uusapan natin ngayon is about thermodynamic systems and control volume. So, hindi na natin ito patatagalin pa, kaya let us dive into our discussion. So, pag-usapan muna natin kung ano ba yung tinatawag nating system in thermodynamics. A system is defined as a quantity of matter or a region in space chosen for study. Well, in every engineering analysis, mahalaga na maging specific tayo or precise kung ano ba talaga yung pinag-aaralan natin. In that way, we will be able to understand kung ano yung mga bagay na nangyayari sa ating subject of study, considering the other factors na pwedeng maka-apekto dito. For example, sa physics or mechanics. If the motion of a body is to be determined, katulad nitong nakikita natin sa picture ngayon, normally the first step is to define a free body, and identify all the forces exerted on it by other bodies. So, katulad na nakikita natin dito sa ating example picture, first, ina-identify natin yung ating free body, and then we will identify all the forces that is exerted by other bodies that may affect the motion of our free body. And now, considering all of this factor, we will now apply the Newton's second law of motion. So, just the same sa nakita natin dito, in thermodynamics, it is very important na properly identify natin yung object na ating pinag-aaralan. And in thermodynamics, the term system is used to identify the subject of the analysis. And our system can be as simple as a free body, katulad nung nakita natin kanina, or it can be as complex as a refinery or an electric power plant. And once the system is defined and the relevant interactions with other systems are identified, one or more physical laws or relations are applied. Now let us consider this figure right here. Well, in here, makikita natin ang ating system, which is inside the broken red lines right here. And then sa labas ng ating system is what we called the surroundings. The surroundings is the mass or region outside the system. So, lahat ng nasa labas ng ating system ay tinatawag nating surroundings. And then, we have here what we call the boundary. The boundary is the real or imaginary surface that separates the system from its surroundings. Well, itong boundary ang nagiging batayan natin kung hanggang saan ang sakop ng ating system. And that means that our boundary is the surface that is shared by the system and the surroundings. We have to take note that the boundary of a system can be fixed or movable. Ipapakita natin yan mamaya as we go on in our discussion. Well, mathematically speaking, the boundary has zero thickness, and thus, it can neither contain any mass nor occupy any volume in space. Therefore, we don't have to worry kung gaano ba kalaking space ang na-occupy ng ating boundary. And now, let us discuss the different types of systems. Simulan natin yung tinatawag nating closed system. Closed system consists of a fixed amount of mass and no mass can cross its boundary. That is, no mass can enter or leave a closed system. But energy in the form of heat or work can cross the boundary, and the volume of a closed system does not have to be fixed. So, it is clear sa ating definition that in a closed system, the mass inside the system doesn't change. Therefore, there is no mass from outside the system can enter, and there is no mass from inside our system can get out of our boundary. So therefore, our mass inside our system remains constant. But on the other hand, ito namang energy natin can enter and can come out. So there is transfer of energy sa ating system and the surrounding. Well, that is what we called a closed system. Now, as mentioned, the volume of a closed system does not have to be fixed. So, we need to take note of that. Dahil kahit na ito ay closed system, ang volume niya pwede pa rin magbago. And an example of that is a gas in a piston cylinder assembly. Because as you can see here, we have a gas inside a boundary. But as the piston moves, the volume of our system will increase. We'll have a look at this another example. So, in here, meron tayong moving boundary. And we have a gas with definite weight and definite volume, which is 2 kg and 1 cubic meter. Now, we applied additional energy here, no, in a form of heat. And then, our gas expands to 1.5 cubic meter volume, while ang ating mass remains the same at 2 kg. So as you can see, in a closed system, nananatiling constant yung ating mass. But then, our volume changes when additional energy is applied. So this is an example of a moving boundary. Well, di ba kanina sa ating definition, nabanggit natin that a boundary can be fixed or moving. Well, this is an example of a moving boundary. And then we have what we call an isolated system. Well, kung dito sa ating closed system, the mass cannot cross its boundary, but the energy in a form of heat or work can cross the boundary, no? So, yung energy can cross the boundary, but the mass cannot cross the boundary. Now, in an isolated system, neither the transfer of mass nor the energy takes place across its boundary with the surrounding. So, in a closed system, yung energy natin can be transferred or cross the boundary. But in an isolated system, even energy cannot cross our boundary. Okay, so in an isolated system, both mass and energy cannot cross our boundary. And of course, kung meron tayong closed system, meron din tayong tinatawag na open system. So, ano ba itong tinatawag nating open system? An open system is a system in which the transfer of mass as well as energy can take place across its boundary. So, kung ang isolated system, hindi nakaka-cross ang mass and energy, well, dito naman sa open system, both mass and energy can cross the boundary. So, kung iisipin natin, in a closed system, madaling analyze kasi yung mass natin remains constant, no? Well, lalo naman in an isolated system dahil there will be no energy influence from the surrounding. So, how do we study a system where mass and energy can pass through the boundary? Well, we cannot ignore this because this type of system is happening in many processes. This is the case for automobile engines, for turbines, and for pumps. And of course, marami pa na hindi natin nabanggit. So, how do we study this type of system? We do that by studying a particular quantity of matter as it passes through the device. A region within the prescribed boundary is therefore studied. The region is called a control volume. Mass may cross the boundary of a control volume. Where on this type of system, our boundary can be real or imaginary or can be both. Okay, so let us have a look at this example. So, this is our control volume right here. So, meron tayong boundary which is represented by this broken line. Okay, so this is an open system because as you can see, mass can enter our boundary from here. Okay, so here we have a fixed boundary. So bakit ito naging fixed boundary? Because it remains the same, no, throughout the process. And on this portion, we have a moving boundary. So this piston may move upward depending on the condition produced by our surrounding, no? And then we have another case here. We have our control volume right here. And this example is for a nozzle. So in here, meron tayong real boundary right here. Okay? But in here, we do not have a real boundary kasi continuous yung flow ng ating fluid in here, no? So if this is our region of study or our system, then we are setting an imaginary boundary right here. Because ito ang portion na ating kino-consider in our study. Now, there are two point of view that we can consider in studying thermodynamics. And this is what we call the macroscopic and the microscopic views of thermodynamics. So, what is the macroscopic point of view? This sometimes called as the classical thermodynamics. It is concerned with the gross or overall behavior. There is no model of the structure of matter at the molecular, atomic, and subatomic level is directly used in classical thermodynamics. On this approach, a certain quantity of matter is considered, without the events occurring at the molecular level being taken into account. So dito, hindi natin kino-consider yung molecular level, no? When we are studying thermodynamics. And that goes here sa microscopic point of view. which is also called as statistical thermodynamics. It is concerned directly with the structure of matter. The objective is to characterize by statistical means the average behavior of the particles, making up a system of interest, and relate this information to the observed macroscopic behavior of the system. And now let us discuss the property and state of a system. So, una, ano ba itong tinatawag nating property? Property is a characteristic of a system which can be quantitatively evaluated. So, some of the familiar properties are pressure, temperature, volume, mass, etc. So, ito yung mga example ng mga tinatawag nating property. And of course, we are all familiar with this because napag-aralan na natin to in chemistry, physics, and other fields of engineering. And meron tayong dalawang klase ng thermodynamic properties. Una is yung tinatawag nating intensive property. So, ano yung tinatawag nating intensive property? It is the property that does not depend on the mass of the system. So, independent siya sa mass ng system. Some example of an intensive property are temperature, pressure, and density. So, as you can see, itong mga properties na to ay hindi dependent sa mass. For example, itong density. Alam natin na yung density ng particular substance is the same at a given temperature and pressure regardless kung mas malaki yung mass niya or mas maliit yung mass niya. Now, another class of thermodynamic property is what we call an extensive property. So, an extensive property are those whose values depend on the size or extent of the system. So, ito naman, dependent naman itong mga property na to sa mass. Okay, its value varies directly with mass. So, some examples are mass, volume. Now, extensive properties per unit mass are called specific properties. For example, we have what we call specific volume, which is volume over mass, and specific total energy, which is energy over mass. So, ano naman yung tinatawag nating state? State refers to the condition of a system as described by its properties. For example, temperature and pressure may describe the state of a gas. So, consider again this picture right here. When a gas expands in a cylinder, the piston moves upward. Therefore, the properties of the system change and the system reaches to the new state. So, therefore, na-identify natin yung condition ng ating system by using the properties. And this condition is what we call the state of our system. Well, in our next videos, pag-aaralan natin yung iba't ibang properties as well yung iba't ibang mga factors na importante sa pag-aaral natin ng thermodynamics such as temperature, pressure, density and specific gravity, force, energy, and work. Well, that's it for now guys and thank you for watching. We would like to ask for your support by subscribing sa aming YouTube channel and click on the notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga videos na pinopost namin. So, we would like also to invite you to register sa aming website, which is www.enginerds.org. It is an online community for Filipino engineers, engineering students, and STEM students. Thank you very much and have a nice day.